Yo, 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 what's happening, everybody? I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. What do you do, buddy? I teach the world over accounting by building block, building block, building block, building block, the basics. I'm a fundamental kind of guy. You know what I'm saying? I happen to have the best playlist in the world. It's right over here. Just click this card right here. It's the best playlist in the world. It's the best accounting playlist for shizzle, for shigadales in the world. You know what it is. This is my classic series. My classic series. Can you believe it? We're on number 82. What's that? 82. Si, señor. Habla español poquito. Sí, sí. Mucho trabajo. Mucho trabajo. Sí. So anyways, but also this is a sub-series. I believe this is going to be number, because this is a Friday video, because I know, because 7782, I just know it's a Friday video. This happens to be, you know, filmed a different time. Anyways, this is the 10th series in a series. Can you believe that? So, I mean, I make these boards in the morning. I get here at 3 in the morning. I try to stay positive. This is September 2017. This is my positivity month. So do not let me do anything but positivity. But it's very hard. Let's go. This is the 10th, 82nd and the 10th one. Let's go. Let go. We're going to do accounts payable. Oh, how could I forget DC Adler? This is why you would watch me. DC Adler, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. That's why you would know me. This is a real spill, helped tens and thousands upon thousands of people learn accounting better, the basics better. And a lot of people, that's all they need is the basics. They're not trying to be like accountants. And even accountants need to know the basics. But anyways, so what are we doing this one? We're doing accounts payable. We've done accounts payable many times, but on this mini series, I guess, series in a series, we do a journal entry. Then we go and how it corresponds to the chart of accounts. Then how it corresponds to the general ledger. Then after that, how it corresponds to the balance sheet and income statement. So, I'm going to go through this journal entry rather fast. It's an accounts payable journal entry. I've done, I think, a couple videos on accounts payable on my channel, in my classic series, in my AFB Accounting for Beginners classic series. So if you don't really understand how I got accounts payable or what accounts payable is about, please look at my previous videos. Thank you very much. Now we go forward. All right, what happens? So this is our little mini business. I'll say what I was gonna say, but anyways, just let all the stressors go out of your life. This is, it's a stressful world in the, you know, just turn the news on for 5 minutes, you know, and you'll get stressed out. So I want this to be kind of a positive, non-stressful learning environment, you know, that I just want you to feel like kind of warm and fuzzy when you're here studying with me or just, so anyways, let's go. This is my favorite thing to do, is do these accounting, because I know that these are actually like changing people's lives, like these Accounting for Beginners videos, and it's a good feeling. And let's go, let go. Right, I'm on my feels, boy. So Widget Incorporated gets $5,000 in widget supplies on account. All right, because I needed, our company needs some supplies. $5,000 worth of supplies. We got a big repair job. But you would be able to look at our balance sheet, or you would probably know in our bank account we only have $2,000 right now. So we got other, you know, small bills probably coming up and everything. So we don't want to spend that. So we basically, you know, accounts receivable is the other, you know, accounts receivable is someone kind of finesses us and doesn't pay us. You know, accounts receivable is we front somebody. They're gonna pay. This is accounts payable. This is us. This is us finessing somebody. We just got finessed, so we got to finesse somebody else. This is kind of what business is, really. It's just smoke and mirrors. That's why it's always like, just how much cash do you have? You know, it's all smoke and mirrors. And that's why if you can read a balance sheet, like you're going to start learning how to read balance sheets and try to delve just one step deeper into it and see exactly what's going on. Because you're going to see on our balance sheet income statement, we're going to have accounts receivable, accounts payable. I mean, what does it all mean? what would you do with that? You would say widget supplies on account. Okay, on account. So we're getting. What is a widget supply? Widget supplies is going to be an expense, but we're getting something and we're not paying for it, like a trade. Like it's in your ordinary everyday trade. Like that's like a trading account, because like widget supplies is like my main thing. So we don't, if think about it, if we usually paid for it, we'd have a credit of cash, but we don't pay for it. So instead of that, we are gonna have accounts payable. Because instead of paying someone with cash, we're writing them really an IOU, I'll pay you later, accounts payable. Accounts payable happens to be a liability because you're liable for it, you're gonna pay that later. And it's going up in value, so it's going to be a credit. So accounts payable, 5,000 credit is a liability. And then what are you getting for that $5,000 in account? You're getting widget supplies. So widget supplies is just maybe because it aids in help in repairing the widgets. It might be little pieces. It might be a cost of goods sold, possibly. But we're not splitting them up like that. It's just an expense for us. So that's at 1031, what happened. I feel like I'm going really slow. I want to get to different boards. Anyways, if I went too fast on this, I have many other accounts payable journal entries. Okay, let's go to the second board. Okay, great. Everybody can see everything. We're on our second board. Oh, I want to get, okay, so this one is kind of going to be fun, I guess. Let's just see what happened. What did we do? What two accounts did we just use? We just used an accounts payable, and we used a widget supply in our journal entry. Now, we had to make two new ones. Let's go to the liability, the accounts payable. We did not have that in our chart of accounts, so we added it in when we made our journal entry. Easy, right? We make new charts all the time. Sorry, that's my 5:15 alarm. Sorry, that's my 5:15 alarm. Sorry, but this is a non-working out day. I got two more videos planned for today. So what a blessed life, right? I'm filming now, then I'm gonna film another video, then I'm gonna lift, and then I'm gonna film another video. So I'm blessed. What can you say, right? Glass half full. So yeah, in our chart of accounts, you know, sometimes like, you know, in the ordinary course of a business, this is what we do, a business cycle. You're going to have times when you make journal entries when you're already going to have the account. And then you're going to have journal entries where you're going to need new ones like this one. So we added in our expenses. We have other expenses. We have computer and internet, office expenses, independent contractor, rent expenses. These are all expenses. And then we just added another one to the expenses, widget supplies. And on liabilities, we added accounts payable to loan from shareholder. So these are all our different charts on chart of accounts that we've used for journal entries that we've used in our business and previous journal entries. This month at 10:31, oh, I guess it's Halloween, boo-hoo. Boo-hoo, oh, don't be so sad. And so these are the first. So let's go in our general ledger. Let's take a snapshot inside of the accounts, in the chart of accounts. So what did we use? We used accounts payable. Here's the accounts payable. And we used widget supplies. Here's the widget supplies general ledger accounts. These are the first time we used either of them. So they are just, you know, $10,000 in accounts payable. And widget supplies, $10,000, $10,000. Booyah, let's move to my favorite board. Okay, yes, I said this is my favorite board. This is definitely my favorite board because I think, you know, as a CPA, as a certified public accountant, as one of the 500,000 certified public accountants in America, I would like to say, yes, that is the top of my profession. Yes, it is all I'm trying to say is that what do I want to see? If I want to see the business in like 2 seconds, I would say balance sheet. Give me the balance sheet. Give me the balance sheet income statement. Balance sheet on top, of course. Anyways, so if you can start reading this, I mean, you've got multi-millionaire people who don't know how to read a balance sheet. Should I buy this business? Well, read the balance sheet. I don't know how to read it. I do. You know, wiggle your way in there, buddy. It's all about conning people, right? Confidence. It's all about confidence. Everything in life is about confidence and consistency. Confidence and consistency. Woo! Balance sheet, income statement. I've talked so much. I only have like 3 minutes. I'm going to roll through. What happened on this balance sheet and income statement? Sorry, this one's going to suck at the end, I think. Balance sheet and income statement. What did we do? We did an accounts payable. And we did a widget supplies. So let's go to the widget supplies because that happened to be an expense. So that did affect. So that affected the income statement, and that journal entry affected the balance sheet because one was an expense, one was a liability, right? Right. And so we added an expense for $5,000, taking our total expenses to $18,000. We had from this time period of 1/1/15 to 10/31/15, so this whole 10 months since we've been open, we made $22,000 in income or in revenue, minus our expenses of $18,000. We have net income of $4,000. So that changed, right? We did have net income of $9,000 that we just lost at, right? Now we're at $4,000 in income. $4,000 net income from the income statement transfers over to the net income of the balance sheet in the equity section. Net income, big number, right? It's on the income statement and the balance sheet, right? How much money do you make? Big one, right? Okay, woo. So what happened was I talked a lot in the beginning of the video. My camera cuts out at 16 minutes because it says, Hey, fat boy, you've been talking too long. But then I was like, you know what, I'll just cut out some of that trash in the beginning and then actually have a good lesson on what I say my favorite board is, because I tend to rush on the last board. This is my favorite board, the balance sheet board. Anyways, where was I? Jeez, I'm crowbars. All right, we're done with the income statement, and that's why the balance sheet's on top, because whatever happened to our income and expenses is our net income or net loss, and that transfers over to the bottom of the balance sheet on the equity. So, what is the balance sheet? That is the Probably that's, if there is one piece of paper that I wanted to see a business, it's going to be the balance sheet. And that's what I need. The assets equal liabilities plus equity, the balance sheet. I wouldn't say, let me see the journal entries, or let me see the general ledger. You know, that could be hundreds and hundreds and thousands of pages. Just let me see this real fast. So what did we add or change on the balance sheet? Well, we changed our net income, because we had a change in the income statement of revenue expenses. So slow down for a second. That's to be expected, right? Slow down. I think people go too fast and they say, I don't know how to do this, and they get all frazzled. Just slow down. I know you don't know how to do this. That's why you're watching. Just slow down and if you can slow down what happened for me, if I could slow down. I act like it's easy to slow down. It's not. You know, just slow down. And then, I can see it in my head. That's why I use widgets. Because I want you to use what you can see in your head happening, you know, with an accounts payable. And, you know, that's why I say, like, oh, they're never going to pay you back. And, you know, stuff like that. You know, or I'm never going to pay them. Or I'm going to pay them, but I have accounts receivable. So, if you can see what's going on, you know, in your head, just slow down, and then you will know it when you go faster. So, you know, it might take you longer to learn something than other people. Don't worry about that. What else changed on our balance sheet? Accounts payable changed. We added that. We added that for $5,000. So that's a liability. Other liability we had was loan from shareholder. That's $7,000. So we have $12,000 in liability and then $4,000 under equity in net income. Because think about it, that's what the kind of the business has made, right? That's the equity. Because it's assets equal liabilities plus equity. Assets is what's in the business, and then liabilities and equities is, well, this is what's in the business. See, and then the other side of what's in the business is, do you owe it to somebody, or does the business own those assets? So look, out of the 16,000, you have 12,000 that somebody else owe, but you owe to somebody else, or that somebody else owns, or whatever. So you own 4,000 of the 12,000. I guess that is what it is, right? So yeah. So but your assets are 16,000 because you have assets equal liabilities plus equity. So 16,000 equals 16,000. So my story checks out. His story checks out. But what is in that 16,000? Basically you only have $2,000 in your checking account, and then you didn't have money for supplies, so you had to get those fronted to you. So then you owe the shareholder, that's yourself. I mean, it's just been a money pit, so you yourself took, you know, $7,000 of your own money and at this point and put it in here. And then you just borrowed $5,000 more, right? Man, if this guy with $10,000 would pay you, geez, I'm crow. So there's all this different valuing your business, how you're going to value your business. But I've talked so much on this one, you know, a little different, I guess. I'm going to try to slow up and talk a different, or just, I'm just going to do what I want because this is my series, basically. But I'm going to try to make the best content. I'm going to try to give you what's going on in my head with journal entries and chart of accounts and journal ledgers and balance sheet and income statement, because that's, I think, what happened. That's how I learned the most. So anyways, I hope to see you on the next one. If you did, like, share, subscribe, share the accounting knowledge. You know, I give it away to everybody. I want everybody in the world. I want every beginning accounting student to know about DC Adler. You know, I want them to have that in their toolbox. But anyways, have a great day. Deuces.